In case you missed it, the Hoos were handed a dramatic loss in overtime by the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets on Saturday. The final score? GT 30, UVA 27. I'm Rob Denny, and these are Rob's Reasons. Number one, less than special teams. So maybe I jinxed this one with my praise of the unit last week, but wow, were they bad. With a clean performance from this group, the Cavs would have won this game handily. And the problems really started with a poorly played punt return, which left the offense starting from the 1 yard line. One sack and 2 points later, the Cavs had to punt, and the Yellow Jackets took it all the way back for a touchdown. Later on, another misplayed punt bounced off the leg of an unaware Who, and Georgia Tech recovered the ball, capitalizing with a touchdown. We know how this one ended, with a missed Brian Delaney field goal in overtime. I have no words. Number two, run defense. Georgia Tech attempted 8 passes and completed just 1. For the Yellow Jackets, that's a lot of passes, but for just about any other team, that's incredibly few. Without much of an aerial attack to speak of, the UVA defense had one job, and one job only, stop the run. Instead, the Hoos gave up 268 yards on the ground, failing to keep the Yellow Jackets out of manageable third down situations all night long. This is extremely crucial when competing against a run-first offense, because giving up 7 yards on first and second downs plays right into Georgia Tech's strength, allowing them to run on third down as well. Wahoo defenders tackled soft, and Georgia's ball carriers always fell forwards, gaining costly extra yards after contact. This team knew how to game plan Georgia, and they just didn't execute accordingly. Number three, Bryce came back again, Bryce is back, tell a friend. Of course, with the Big Tech game coming up next week, a healthy Bryce Perkins is a must. After sustaining a brutal hit on a safety, he left the game briefly in the first half, but all of Charlottesville let out a collective sigh of relief when he returned later in the game. Fortunately, he looked no worse for the wear and ran into the end zone shortly after coming back into the game. While the outcome of this one is disappointing, to say the least, Wahoo fans can remain excited for the biggest matchup of the season on Friday night. The past couple of weeks have seen too many players injured, so a clean bill of health for the Hoos quarterback couldn't be more crucial. This was a brutal loss, but try to keep those heads up, Wahoo fans, and most importantly, beat Tech.